Yes. Good morning, guys. Your boy Vic Cizo once again. And of course, I'm here to discuss Adlisa. Every morning, I'm discussing Adlisa questions. I'm here to answer your Adlisa questions. Today, I have like 10 questions. So stay tuned. Like the video, subscribe, share, comment down below whatever you want me to share on my next video. Go follow me on Instagram at Vic Cizo. And of course, Question number one is, can MOI, that's Ministry of Interior Qatar, cancel my visa transfer if the company delays to attest the contract? Yes. Even after you've been approved, if your new company doesn't attest the contract online, the approval expires and you'll have to again to apply again. So that's why it's advisable as early as possible after the notice period is done, let the new company start processing your documents, let them give you a contract to sign and let them upload so that the process of your QID can start immediately. Otherwise, the approval also expires. Next question is, I applied 2 days ago. Is it okay to start doing follow-ups? Yes, follow-ups you can even start on that same day, no problem. As long as all we want is to get approved. Next person is saying, transferred. Okay, this guy was working in Qatar 2 years ago. He got deported because of trespassing. Now he's saying he's back to Qatar. When he checks online the visa, it says it has been transferred to residence, and when he checks on the MOI, it says the QID has been cancelled. So he got an offer letter and is asking, is it possible now to get a new visa with another company? Yes. What it means by it has been transferred to residence is when you arrived in Qatar the first time, you came with your visa, then that visa only lasts for 3 months. So immediately you are given the QID, the status of the visa will change that you are in the country, the visa has already been used, and it has been transferred to the QID. So the visa is no longer valid, now it's the QID you'll be talking about. And then, if your QID has been cancelled, it means, yes, you are no longer in the system. You have to apply again, okay? That means even your visa is cancelled. Let's see the next person. So if you get the offer letter, let them apply for you everything again. Let's see the next person here is saying, I applied and my company can my company cancel my visa or QID? Even though you have applied on Adlisa, that doesn't mean that you have been approved, or that doesn't mean that your company cannot cancel your QID. They will cancel definitely if they are haters and they are jealous people. They will cancel your QID and visa, and the process will reject. Okay, the process will reject. Just pray when you are applying for change of employer, make sure you are in good terms with your company. Don't mess them up before you apply. They can also get angry and cancel your everything. Though if you have gotten an offer letter, there is guys, let me advise you this. This is very important for you. Even if your company threatens to deport you back home, the first thing you should do is try and find ways to record whoever is telling you that will deport you. Those conversations, you can use them against them in court. And once your company has decided to threaten you that they will deport you because you got an offer letter from another company that's against the labor laws of Qatar, so go to the labor offices and file a case against them. You will be summoned, and they will also be summoned. You will meet there. And the thing is, even those judges in the Ministry of Labor, they are aware that there are companies that feel like it's better if they deport you back to your country than let you go free to another company here in Qatar and be earning more money in another company. So, because those are human beings, what they do, They will ask the company, does it cost you anything when this person transfers to another employer here in Qatar? The company, of course, will say, no. Does it cost you when you are deporting him to their own country? Yes, because they have to pay for the ticket. Then the question will be, why will you enjoy spending money to pay someone his ticket back home when you can just leave them here to change the company? Because at long last, they will not be working for you freely. So they find out that these people are just jealous people who don't want the best for their employees, okay? They don't want the employees to grow. And then what they will tell them is, young man or young lady, go and join whichever company you are joining, and your current employer is told, don't do anything like that. So yeah, as long as you show evidence of everything, you will be given an opportunity to join another company, even if they have cancelled your QID. Another thing is, my QID is expiring in the next 2 months. What can I do? Please go make follow-ups. If you already applied on AdLisa, email them daily. Check the emails on my description box. I'm always singing this and I'm repeating myself daily. Please follow up. Text them on Twitter. Google AdLisa Twitter. It will pop up, okay? Their emails are there. Call them. Be consistent. It doesn't cost anything. You have free Wi-Fi. Send emails, okay? And then the next person is termination during probation. So what happens if you get a termination during your probation period? If you already have a QID, use that termination letter to apply for another company. Use it as an NOC or a resignation letter. When you are applying on AdLisa, use it as evidence that you are no longer needed in the current company, so you are free to go and join another company, okay? Getting a termination letter during probation in a company is the same as you resigning or terminating your contract with that company during probation. And during probation period, you can be told, don't come tomorrow, okay? Or you can also resign to the company and tell them, I will not be working from tomorrow. Because during probation period, it doesn't need a 1 month notice period. No, it can be terminated immediately. So terminations during probation is because you have not met their standards, because the probation period is the period where you're supposed to do your best for the employer to see that you are really worth it. Otherwise, during probation, if you don't behave, yes, you will get that termination letter. And then, but it's not the end of the road, guys. You can join another company which may require you. Can employer cancel visa? Yes, employer can cancel a visa anytime, whether you have applied on AdLisa or not. They will always cancel. But I've told you, if the employer cancels your everything and wants to send you back home, report the case. If you are not ready to go back home, don't go. Report the case to the Minister of Labor. They will assist you. And first, you must find an offer letter from another company before even you go to file a case for them. Yeah, they will consider if you already got an offer letter here, the judges will consider you, okay? Then the last question is, after approval, the company told me they will give me my settlement once I show them their QID. So how long does the QID take after approval? So after approval, the next thing is attestation of the contract. Yeah, after notice period, attestation of the contract, which takes few days. You sign the contract, they attest it. In 2-3 weeks, your QID arrives. So people asking for settlement, you will never be given settlement if you have not been fully transferred to the new company. The new company, once they have given you their QID, it means you are no longer in the previous sponsor. That's when the previous sponsor will give you the settlement. Otherwise, if you have not received the new QID, it means you are still under the current sponsor and there is no way they can settle you if you are still in the country. Unless you are exiting the country, they will settle you. Or you move to the next company and you get the QID, they will give you the settlement. That's according to the laws. And yeah, that's it for today. Guys, please, if you know any companies recruiting from Kenya, let me know. I'm ready to give them guys for free. I don't judge anything. I don't charge anything. And so that the employees don't have to go through the agencies, because going through the agency, you have to pay them a lot of money. There's commissions, and you know, not everyone has the commission fee that agencies back at home request for or demand for. Okay, so go follow me on Instagram, DM me, follow me, comment down below whatever you want me to share on the next one. Peace out.